thanks to the big pass catch by Dawkins for 42 yards. Second down and six. And Harbaugh with plenty of time throwing it out of bounds. It was Dilger, the tight end, in the vicinity.
Good choice by Harbaugh. Just heave it out of there. We go back to that big catch by Sean Dawkins. If there's one failing of this Kansas City defense in 1996, it's the big plays that they have given up. In fact, didn't Marty Schottenheimer tell us yesterday? He's a numbers guy. Said they gave up, they've given up 56 plays of 20 yards or more in this 1996 season.
Right.
You add to that today, there's been three or four over 20 yards. And they're good on first and second down, and suddenly they give up the big play.
He says third down has been killing this football team. And a timeout is called by the Colts, their first of this second half.
Like all Americans, I like big things. Big prairies. Big forests and mountains. Big wheat fields. And everything else.
Though he thinks a diet soft drink never tastes as good as a regular, he's decided to try a Diet Dr. Pepper. Well, it just goes to show things aren't always what they seem. Diet Dr. Pepper tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper.
As long as this thing's been going, we've been chasing it. It's an obsession with us.
We've gone days without seeing anything.
Stop! Stop! No!
Yeah, over there.
It's a woodchuck.
Nothing, right?
It's a woodchuck. Sorry. It's going and going, and therefore you yourself have to keep going and going.
Let's go, guys. I need a play down here.
Hang on, Mike.
We're working on something up here.
I tried three wide rocket.
If they blitz, it won't work.
What about a quick slant?
Okay, Mike, we're almost there.
Come on.
Look at Pro Split Z out.
What's taking so long up there?
Okay, Mike, here we go. Three wide, 78, Z out, Y cross.
All right, all set. Let's go.
45!
Good call, guys. Good job.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Dr. Pepper is just what the doctor ordered. By Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. By KFC, for everything a meal should be, everybody needs a little KFC. And by American Express, help support the American Express Charge Against Hunger program.
Critical third down attempt here for Indianapolis. Third down and six. Harbaugh's going to work out of the shotgun. They're 6 of 9 on the afternoon. Harbaugh going close to the goal line. It's caught for the first down. Tony Stargell on the coverage. Well, it was a nice catch made by Marvin Harrison, number 88. Already with a couple of touchdown catches to his credit.
Well, it looked nice inside release. Just made Stargell just hesitate for a moment. And, of course, Stargell, I told you earlier, he's now a target. Stargell replacing Dale Carter. And Harbaugh knows it is a major league throw and a major league pattern run by Harrison.
He has come up with some big catches today. First and goal for the Colts. Falk. He's not going to get in.
Good job here by the defensive line, just holding up the offensive line, allowing the linebackers to pursue along the line of scrimmage. They don't have to go back in the end zone. Several people making the hit. Mark, number 71, among a couple others.
Pressed into defensive line duty this week for Kansas City with the injuries they've had up front. Second and goal now. Falk will try it again. This time gets the pitch, and again, Kansas City's defense responds.
When you give a tip of the cap to Martin Bayless, number 21 on the outside, made Marshall Falk step back inside, allow the pursuit to catch up. Minuski, watch 21 come across the line of scrimmage, right? Whoop, makes him jump back inside, and Simeon and Minuski there to make the tackle. He lose 2 yards maybe on that one.
Yeah, they did. They had the first and goal at the one and a half yard line, now backed up to the 5 on third and goal.
Blitz.
four wide outs. That one in and out of the arms of Neil Smith. He had a tailor-made interception.
Oh! He drops in coverage, which is exactly what you want him to do. I guess you can't expect him to make the catch.
And that kind of year for Neil.
90's not supposed to be out there. All of a sudden, he just shows up. And Mander at 79 is the man in trying to block him. Oh, my goodness.
So this to tie the NFL record. This is Terry Blanchard for the chip shot, and he's equaled the NFL record for field goals in a season, 35. He is 35 of 39 on the year.
This holiday season at KFC, get three of our freshly prepared Colonel's Crispy Strips, mashed potatoes and gravy, coleslaw, and a biscuit for just $2.99. It's a meal everybody will love. Everybody.
Mars attacks.
I want the people to know they still have two out of three branches of the government working for them, and that ain't bad.
See the biggest cast on the planet, Mars Attacks. Rated PG-13. Now play at a theater near you.
Someday, my office will have a window. Someday, my boss will be me. Someday, I will meet the man of my dreams. Guess not today.
The Chevy Camaro's 200 horsepower, 3800 V6. Therapeutic, isn't it?
On the first Third Rock Christmas, all new on NBC, Sally works in gift wrap.
Bye-bye now.
Tommy freaks out Santa.
Get a haircut. You look like a girl.
Santa's freak out Harry. Ah! Dick finds a tree.
Hey, buddy, can I help you?
No thanks. I have a chainsaw.
All new Christmas Third Rock, NBC tonight.
That third down play, watch Neil Smith along here. You're going to see Kansas City coming with a blitz. That may have been the biggest defensive play of the game right here. You see the way Neil Smith kind of drifts out. Mandrich is blocking on him, hold him to a three-point field goal, and now Kansas City still in the game at 17-10.
Neil Smith, how many of those interceptions have we seen drop today, really by both teams? Vanover comes out for Kansas City, showing a flash of speed across midfield, makes a nice cut back to the and finally brought down at the 21.
By a man who came back inbounds.
71 yards by Vanover.
And Mark Stock saves his touchdown. Huge play by Kansas City. Young man just 22 years old, already playing in his third season in the NFL. Watch 10 behind Vanover. He's going to show up again. Keep watching 10. He's
great
blocked out of bounds.
Vanover.
Stock is blocked out of bounds, comes back in to make the tackle.
Because that was Gardocki, who was the last Colt there with a chance to get him, and who knows what kind of guarantee that would have been. Kansas City now with great field position at the Colt 21, set up by the Vanover. Kickoff return. Greg Hill with another big chunk. Close to a first down for Kansas City.
Well, Dan, we mentioned earlier that Marty Schottenheimer said, we don't have any game breakers. Vanover is certainly one. And the only way they can really get his hands on the ball is on the kickoff returns. He's yet to really learn the offense. But that defensive stand, a little spark to the team, the return by Vanover. The emotion now clearly on the side of the Chiefs.
Second down and less than a yard. Give it to Hill, and Hill picks up the first down. It'll be first down and goal for Kansas City, trailing 17-10, 11:42 and running left in the game.
Now, when Kansas City's in these situations, they turn it over to the offensive line. This team can play with anybody.
And another Colt is down. That is Tony Bennett, 56. Colts have already been nicked up, a couple of linebackers, Morrison and Grant. But a great kickoff return by Vanover. The Chiefs trying to take advantage.
I go around. I was strong as I could be. I go around. Nothing ever got to me.
We thought this would be a good time to show you around the roomiest extended cab pickup there is. Chevy, the most dependable, longest lasting trucks on the road.
You know how one dog year equals seven human ones? Well, computers are like that compared to other machines. A seven-year-old airplane is younger than a one-year-old server. It makes buying decisions tough. It turns systems into orphans way too soon. Computer people ought to be sensitive to that. No matter how great the new stuff is, they should work with, even optimize their old stuff. Digital does it. Everybody should.
Digital. Whatever it takes.
Only from Domino's. New Garlic Crunch Crust Pizza. Roasted garlic. Baked right into our classic hand-tossed dough. Then sprinkled with Parmesan crunchies all around the edge. It's a delicate blend of herbs and garlic in every bite of our delicious steaming crust. Wow. Call now and get a large one topping just $9.99. New Garlic Crunch Crust for a limited time only.
For hot and wild, call Domino's. Now.
Ho, ho, ho. What would you children like for Christmas?
Lots and lots of snow.
In L.A.? What about you?
How about quartzite seats?
This is tougher than I thought. Anybody else?
How about a Christmas Day doubleheader on NBC?
That I can do.
Lakers, Suns, Pistons, Bulls, a primetime Christmas gift from NBC.
70,000 plus on their feet in Kansas City. First and goal from the seven. Bono working play action to the right, drifting this one to no one.
Yeah, he's trying to run a screen to the tight end. Actually made a good choice. Where Ellis Johnson was chasing him. The screen is going to come to this tight end right here coming in motion. But there's such pressure. Three Colts are right in his face, and the tight end also trips and falls. It's Cashew falls. Gets his feet caught up with one of the offensive linemen.
And numbers for Bono since taking over for Rich Gannon midway through the second quarter. Again, Gannon out of the game. But a strained right hamstring. Whoa. Hill slips at the 11. Well, you mentioned to me during the break, you don't like Kansas City in this position. Why is that?
First and goal at the 7th. One, there's not enough room to really run patterns. And two, you can get the defense up there just all over the offensive line and just a slip there. But look, there's a 10:55 left. Schottenheimer's already got to make the decision. Do we go for it on fourth down? What do we do here? I know third down is coming up, so they need...
Well, there's the guy that's been very vocal on fourth down tries all afternoon, Marcus Allen on the sideline.
This is a tough spot for Kansas City. Run,
Bono being chased, gets rid of it, and it's incomplete.
He could have run it in.
But does he have the mobility to get in? Intended for Keith Cash.
Now Schottenheimer has no choice but to go for the field goal, but if Steve Bono just tucks it under his arm, I give him a 70% chance of scoring. As it was, he threw it right down into the feet of the receiver.
So here is Stojanovic, a 30-yard field goal in the second quarter, and this will be from the identical distance, 30 yards. And Stojanovic pumps it through. And Kansas City didn't get the touchdown, but they do get the field goal.
But watch how open he is. He could have run it in.
Tonight, 20 million Americans will go to bed hungry. But what if you could help more? What if you could do more? Imagine.
Imagine no possessions.
bought something with your American Express card or made a purchase through an American Express financial advisor, you helped feed someone who's hungry. With the charge against hunger, we can all do more.
Chances are, you're going to put more money into their teeth than your Chevy Lumina. Because today's Lumina is so low maintenance, it can actually go 100,000 miles before its first scheduled tune-up. And for you, that's one less thing to worry about. The cars more Americans trust.
Next weekend, 2 days of great NFL action on NBC. Next Saturday at the special time of noon Eastern, Bill Parcells returns to his old haunts as he leads his Patriots against the Giants. Then next Sunday, playoff spots are on the line when the Chiefs battle the Bills or the Steelers collide with the Panthers. The NFL on NBC next weekend.
Steve Bono on the sidelines did have a lot of room to perhaps run that in. We'll show you how much room he had left in a moment.
But Gannon would have run it in.
That's one of the reasons why Schottenheimer made the move to Gannon, but Gannon is out injured. Cliff Gross picks up, actually hands off over to Aaron Bailey, and Bailey picks it up. And he's across the 20 to the 23. And again, the look at how much room Bono had.
Yeah, now here's the tight end, and this is Richard Dent in coverage. You're going to see Bono come out and avoid one tackle, and then he's got an awful lot of room. I may raise my percentages as well as I can get in here. He's at the 15-yard line. He throws the ball into the legs of Richard Dent. Now here's the play of the game. Watch Mark Stock. He keeps going after this play from out of bounds. He makes the tackle on Tamarik Vanover. If he doesn't, I think Gardocki misses the tackle. Chiefs score on a touchdown, tie score.
As it is, they can't take advantage with a touchdown of a 72-yard kickoff return. This is Cliff Gross. So that may indeed be a key play before this one is over. 10 minutes left in the game.
Dan, most players, once they're blocked out of bounds, they pretty much give up on the play. I mean, that's it. But Mark Stock stayed with it. And that could be one of those key little bitty teen little plays that suddenly just mushrooms, just a big cloud over it. Wow, what an effort by Mark Stock.
Stock, a sixth-round pick in 89 by the Steelers. Second down and short. Harbaugh with a fake. Goes to the left side. It's complete. Number 81, Marcus Pollard, the tight end. Anthony Davis on the tackle, along with Mark Collins. But the first catch for Marcus Pollard in just the sixth of the season picks up the first down for Indianapolis.
And Harbaugh has learned this offense so well. Waited and waited and waited, and there's always an outlet receiver in this offense. Found him over there on the sideline. This has been hard work for Lindy and Pine and his staff all season long.
A jigsaw puzzle he and his defensive coordinator Jim Johnson have put together. And on offense, they've been killed by injuries. Harbaugh back for the first time since missing a couple of games with a knee injury and handing off to Falk. Falk quickly dragged down at the 38-yard line by Mark Collins. As we take a look at some of the other scores, Denver 24-12 lead on Oakland with 3:17 left in the third quarter. And the Bengals leading Houston at the Astrodome.
Well, that would ruin Houston's year, wouldn't it, after their great start?
And a final, Dallas over the New England Patriots, 12-6. So Dallas seems to get the big wins when the Cowboys need it. Colts need this win. Second down and six. Harbaugh with time, and that is something he's had a lot of today. That offensive line up front has been doing a good job of protecting Harbaugh. He's only been sacked, I believe, once.
Once, yeah. Pressured maybe a couple of times, you're right. And this is a remade offensive line. They lost three offensive linemen to free agency. And then with all the injuries, they've had to kind of move people around. Of course, Tony Mandarich.
Football for 4 years, and his career resurrected, and he's been going against Neil Smith for most of the afternoon. Third down and six. Again, five wideouts for Harbaugh. Stands in. City 32.
And this formation has made the Chiefs blitz. And every time today, the Chiefs have blitzed against the Colts have beat it. Now again, watch the blitz. It takes a long time for everybody to get there. 50 is blocked well. Again, Harbaugh time stands in there, looking for Aaron Bailey just on the crossing pattern, a little pick run. Brian Stabline knocks off Hasty. Harbaugh makes the completion, another big play against this Kansas City defense.
Hey, they really picked up that blitz well. The Colts blockers up front. Harbaugh had time to get that one to Bailey. And he hands this one off to a spinning Cliff Gross, who's brought down by John Browning.
Cliff Gross, the ball
under the
carrier.
7 minute mark.
He was tackled by John Browning.
Colts with a 17-13 lead.
And you know, we've seen the I've seen the Indianapolis Colts several times this season. I don't know how they do this. I swear, I mean, no turnovers, very few penalties week in and week out, and they got three or four or five new starters in there. They don't make mistakes. They keep functioning as a unit. I mean, you can't give this coaching staff in Indianapolis enough credit for the job that they've got done. He's going to have to take a timeout here.
Doesn't like the looks of this, and yeah. He'll take another timeout. And that is the second one, so the Colts with just one remaining. They have been impressive the last two ball games. Win over Buffalo in overtime, win over Philadelphia, holding both of those teams to 10, and so far Kansas City only has 13 to the Colts 17.
This is for Mr. Blanchard, who told me to make something of myself. For Miss Miller, who never let me settle for a C. For my parents, who believe in my dreams. For myself, for my future.
Be all that you can be.
Well, it's gotten awfully quiet here on Arrowhead, Bob. Can't help but think that the Kansas City fans still remember that jolting Colt win in the first round the playoffs last year, and the Colts on the verge of perhaps trying to spoil Kansas City's season again. Second down and seven. Harbaugh's got another completion, and Cliff Gross has another catch for another Colt first down.
Pass to Cliff Gross.
Anthony Davis and Mark Collins combined to drag Gross down.
Watch the fullback again on the swing pattern, way out in the flat. They run Harrison deep. He's in motion first through the line of scrimmage. He's wide open. Harrison even out there tries to help with Miley Cannon. Maybe I'll block. No, I won't. But continuing to drive the ball down the field. Another wonderful call by Lindy and Fadi.
And another play by a player who's filled in for players who have been injured.
Right.
And not on the team. Gross was on the practice squad most of last year. He's got a couple receptions for 19 yards. Marshall Faulk turns it up. And Faulk is close to another first down.
Man, how about that move? Did you see that? He had Pelham McDaniel 77 inside, James Hasty 40 outside. Watch this move when he gets right out about here. He looks like he's going outside. There's 77 on the inside. There's Hasty on it. Whoops!
That's that right foot with that right toe, too. Yeah. So it does look like it's getting better and better each game.
Very Marshall-like, that particular run right there. 67 yards on the day.
Second and short. A long one. Under 5 minutes left. We'll pick up the first down. It'll be first and goal, Indianapolis.
Now Kansas City's got three timeouts left here. One, the defense has got to hold them to 3 points again. Two, they got to start using those timeouts. Marty's got a lot to consider here. 4:35, 4:34. And this is a team, we were talking about that playoff loss last year. You know, they were 13-3.
8-0 at home.
Yeah. Had the week off and then get just shocked by the Indianapolis Colts.
And Marty and all the players downplay it, but it's been talked a lot here in the local media in Kansas City. Cliff Gross gets the call on a play that really never developed.
Gross on the carry. He was tackled by Neil Smith.
And a timeout.
Marty Schottenheimer wants a timeout.
Carl Peterson wants another defensive stop by Kansas City. General manager.
They got the timeout. That's the defense job in this situation. You want to leave the offense with some time.
A lot of speculation, Bob, as to where Carl Peterson will be next year. His contract will expire. He's put together a great franchise here in Kansas City, but still really hasn't even begun the negotiations, which is a little bit perplexing to some folks.
Well, he and Marty Schottenheimer took a heck of a chance this year. Off a 13-3 record last year, they kept 46 of 53 players. They didn't bring in any free agents. They kept what they had. And it was a gamble. And I think if their receivers had not gotten hurt, it might have been a good gamble. But it's really made it tough on the Kansas City Chiefs as they're trying to get the correct personnel in there. But they're very smart here in using the timeouts defensively.
Well, Marty Schottenheimer's record has been so impressive. But the playoff record not as impressive. 5-10 in the postseason. Second down and goal from the 5. Harbaugh turning to his left and just throwing this one out of bounds. That was a play from an experienced player. Avoided the pressure, the potential sack, and just threw it away.
Just a four-man rush, too. I'm not sure what they're trying to do. They have two tight ends in the lineup. Decent protection. And then you see, finally, Browning puts pressure on Harbaugh, and you're right. He wants his team with another opportunity. Not going to throw it foolishly down there for a turnover. But the downside is, clock stops. That helps the Chiefs.
Stops with 3:52 to go. This is a big third down and goal from the 5. If Kansas City can hold Indianapolis to a field goal, and who else but Marvin Harrison for the touchdown. His third of the game. And he was wide open.
Yeah, I'm not so sure that there shouldn't have been a flag thrown on the pick. Colts ran a beautiful pick to spring Harrison wide open out in the flat.
And that puts Harrison over 100 yards on just 6 catches. 2 back-to-back 100-yard receiving games for the rookie out of Syracuse. And it's turned into a long afternoon for Peterson and the Chiefs.
But they're still in the playoff picture. But now they're win or sit and wait. Win next week and wait.
And Blanchard comes on to tack on the extra point.
And if we go back to the play, this is beautifully executed by the Colts. But here's Harrison coming in motion, a fake upfield, and then this guy kind of right here kind of gets caught in the wash. And you're going to see when Harrison breaks out, there is nobody there to cover him whatsoever. And that's all designed to just create traffic for the guy covering Harrison. And you can see it's done beautifully. Wide open. Second straight 100-yard receiving day for Marvin Harrison.
His 8th on the season. And captain comeback with another touchdown pass. For Harbaugh, that is his 12th on the season. And all Marty Schottenheimer can do is shake his head and maybe start. Now it's too early, but you know the fans here thinking about, oh, now we got to go to Rich Stadium, take on the Buffalo Bills, a team that they have not had a good history with, especially at that venue.
Although there are a few teams that have a good history against the Buffalo Bills at Buffalo.
Especially in December. Impressive day for Harrison. And even more so for the Colts. If they can hold on, it will be their 4th win in their last 5 games. The last 3 in a row would come against Buffalo, Philadelphia, and at Kansas City. Shardotkin gets into it. Van over. See if he can get another kickoff return set up. Chiefs again. Across the 25. Brought down at the 30-yard line. Brought down by Elijah Alexander. Well, next Sunday, more exciting NFL action on NBC. It all starts at 12 noon Eastern with the NFL on NBC. And then most of you will see the Chiefs take on those Buffalo Bills. And some of you will see these Colts travel to Cincinnati to take on the Bengals. So the Colts keeping their playoff hopes alive with a potential victory here today with 3:38 remaining. Others will see the Raiders host the Seahawks or the Steelers square off against the Panthers. That's the NFL on NBC next Sunday at 12 noon Eastern time. As you look at Marcus Allen, you can't help but again think about his comments about how his team has really lacked the focus, and there's lacking the focus. Kimball Anders juggling that.
But that was poorly thrown by Steve Bono. And the injury to Rich Gannon, Bono is the quarterback now for the rest of the season. You can't recover from a strained hamstring that quickly. Again,
well,
thrown low. Thrown low. I mean, that's... You hope that a quarterback 7 yards down the field can hit the guy between the numbers. There's Gannon on the sideline right there. Strained hamstring.
Those are his numbers before leaving midway through the second quarter, and it's been Steve Bono's team ever since. As you mentioned, Trump, probably for the remainder of the season. This time, Anders hangs on.
Get out of bounds.
It's right upfield. Gets some pretty good extra yardage. But the clock does continue to roll. 3:20.
You need time in this situation. Down 24-13. You don't fight for inches. You try to save seconds.
See the timeout situation. Chiefs still with a couple, but trailing by 11. And Anders has it again into Colt territory, close to the first down.
Now see, the Colts are going to give the Chiefs the receptions in the middle of the field.
And Marty calls a timeout.
Make them use the timeouts.
Anders has 6 catches for 80 yards. And we'll remind you of NBC's lineup tonight, all new night of Christmas comedy, starting with all new Christmas episodes of Third Rock and Boston Common. Then Paul Hogan stars in the network premiere Western comedy Lightning Jack. The all new comedy starts tonight right after Dateline here on NBC.
Oh, look at that stadium. Man, they're on I-70 heading home at 4:35.
Well, that loss on Monday night really hurt this club.
Yeah, if they lose today, that'll be five losses in, 7 weeks for the Kansas City Chiefs, and the Colts will have won 4 of their last 5 if things continue this way. That's where the Chiefs had it pictured.
Colts are at Cincinnati next Sunday. A flag comes in as Bono connects again with Anders. Anders picks up the first down, but we'll wait and hear the call from Tom White. Clock stops, 2:45 to go. Indy on top, 24-13.
And again, I don't know how the Indianapolis Colts have done this. I seriously
it
do
is amazing.
Not know.
Yeah, it is.
They win. Let's hear the call here.
Offsides, number 56 defense, line up in the neutral zone. Penalty is declined. First down.
Chiefs will decline the penalty on Tony Bennett, pick up the first down, but it has been a masterful job by Lindy Infante since he took over for Ted Marchibroda.
What I was going to say was that they won 2 games when Harbaugh was out with Paul Justin, who played in Arena Football League, the World Football League, you name a league, he's played in it. And then last week when Justin gets hurt, Kerwin Bell comes in.
Takes his first NFL snaps.
And goes 5 for 5 in the NFL.
Leads the team to 2 scores on 2 consecutive possessions. It doesn't matter who the Colts put out there. They just produce. Keith Cash with the reception. As we get closer to the 2-minute warning, Bono trying to hurry it up. Carl wants to hurry him up as well. Colt 36, second down and 5. Bono looks right, goes left. LaChapelle with a nice move. Now he tries to get out of bounds.
And does.
Stops the clock, 2:12. Nice play by LaChapelle. This team really has missed the services of Lake Dawson, though.
Yeah, and also the injury to Vanover, where he gained a little weight, kind of lost all of the sense he had of the offense when he was out with the cracked ribs.
There is Vanover.
But he had the big kickoff return that almost got the Chiefs back in it.
72 yards. He was the only player in the league to score on punt return, kickoff return, and a reception last year, but he has been slowed a little by the injuries this year. Bono gets decked as he got rid of it. Flying the hit was number 53, Sammy Burroughs, free agent rookie out of Portland State.
Boy, Burroughs is untouched, too. You're going to see him come absolutely clean. Bono does a great job of just getting the ball off. He's just throwing the thing away.
Second and 10. Did it seem to you that Steve Bono was a little bit in shock when he came off the bench today in the middle of the second quarter? It just seemed like the Gannon injury happened such in a hurry, and for a guy that normally is the starter, it just didn't seem like he was geared into coming in.
And now they need Bono. Now the entire rest of the season in the playoff picture rides on Bono's shoulders.
Well, Bono steps up this time and not able to make the catch was Chris Penn. As we have reached the two-minute warning in Kansas City, Chiefs trail by 11.
Staples presents the Coach of the Week and congratulates Spring Hill Elementary for winning $5,000 in school supplies. Last week, Tony Dungy, June Jones, and Bill Cower all schooled their opponents. Which one of these leaders captured the sweetest victory? Stay tuned.
What do you see?
Just a bunch of stuff from Staples.
A brother label maker. I could use that. All right, a brother fax. Oh. A brother typewriter. A water gun.
Busted.
Get brother products at the guaranteed low price and 7,000 other great gift ideas. Staples. Yeah, we've got that.
Last week, Tampa Bay dominated the Redskins. The Buccaneers capitalized on two Washington turnovers and never looked back. The victory was the fourth straight home win for the Bucs and makes Tony Dungy the main man of Week 15.
It's not surprising when people discover Diet Dr. Pepper actually tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper. They find it hard to keep it to themselves. Diet Dr. Pepper tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper.
You know, racing for Interstate means my battery has enough power to run my car, as well as some other race necessities, like this mini fridge, my foot massager. Heck, I even had a big screen put in for my friends.
NBC Thursday. It's the most unbelievable, unlikely, unholy alliance in the history of mankind.
An alliance?
An alliance.
An all-new Seinfeld, You've Got to See to Believe, NBC Thursday.
Look at your MVP for the Colts, Trump.
Start. Stock and Marvin Harrison. The tackle, the only time we called Mark Stock's name all day. Harrison's three touchdown receptions.
Kansas City trying to make it interesting on third down. Bono steps up, fires, and off the mark. That was Keith Cash again. And that will bring up fourth down. Well, following the conclusion of this game, we will be sending you to Denver for the end of the Broncos-Raiders game. Denver out in front 24-12, so hang on for that. 1:55 remaining in this one.
Well, you know, Dan, Kansas City's got some rebuilding to do. That is confidence. Steve Bono to go to Buffalo next week and make it hopefully a trip to the playoffs with a win. They've got some major ego rebuilding to do here in this week.
Well, there'll be some nervous Chiefs fans watching it. In Kansas City, Bono trying to keep the hopes alive. And at La Chapelle with a brilliant catch to keep it alive. He has come up with some key receptions for Kansas City this season.
Yeah, you always see this kid stretched out too, don't you? Watch that second foot. Possession, second foot in. Doesn't get much better than that. And Dedrick Mathis there in coverage. That's beautifully done by La Chapelle. All that practice he had in the World League, you know, their most valuable player in that league last spring.
Set the World League record with over 1,000 receiving yards. Kansas City with a drive alive, first and 10, just outside the 10. Bono goes down at the 10. Clock rolling, 1:42 and counting. Chiefs with one timeout left. Bono will try to hurry his team to the line. Well, if Kansas City can get a touchdown here, go for two, be within a field goal and an onside kick, it's a lot to ask for. But
are we going to finish today with all that stuff you're talking about?
As you take a look at some of the other scores, there's that Denver score we alluded to. The Broncos trying to hold on and rebound after that lopsided loss at Green Bay. And Cincinnati pouring it on the Houston Oilers. Cardinals have come back against the Redskins.
What's happened to the Redskins?
Cowboys gets a big win at home over the Patriots. San Francisco is really in command of that game with the Steelers throughout. Carolina, 11-4.
Pretty remarkable, isn't it?
Second year team.
I mean, they win the division, the NFC West. Is that confirmed yet? San Francisco beat Pittsburgh, but that's amazing. Second year in existence.
Third down and four to go.
Let's.
Bono gets rid of it, and they have the touchdown to Kimball Anders, but a flag is down at the 2-yard line.
There's a penalty flag down.
Tom White quickly conferring with his line judge, and here we go.
Holding, defense,
touchdown.
Penalty is declined, touchdown.
So now you go for two.
Let's see, 21, and a field goal ties it. Or do you go for the extra point? Well, you're right. I think you
got to
go
for two. Yeah. Onside kick, try to get the field goal, and hopefully, miraculously, send it into overtime. And it's no surprise that Marcus Allen is the deep back. No surprise he gets it, but the Colts right there. That was Jason Belcher.
Jim Johnson certainly proud of his defense and their job today. Again, a couple of linebackers go down. They put other guys in there and things work. You're going to see the reception right here. It's a halfback circle. And the Colts come with, they blitz everybody but the head coach. It's well picked up.
And
Kimball Anders over Dedrick Mathis for the touchdown, and this wasn't even close. This two-point conversion. The handoff to Marcus Allen. He's met in the backfield by Jason Belcher. And of course, big tackle for Jason Belcher. He's got 30 members of his family here. Grew up here in Kansas City. Dad played for Kansas City.
Went to high school here. A star at Raytown South for the Cardinals.
This upcoming is the best play in football. Onside kick. Absolutely the best play in football.
Well, now Kansas City will need a touchdown. Field goal won't get it done. As they are down by five, but Louis Aguiar.
I love this play. There's never been a boring onside kick. You know that?
Kind of reminds me of the penalty shot in hockey, the free shot in hockey.
This is a 22-man jump ball.
Minute 17 left, Kansas City. With the onside kick, pops up pretty nicely. Whoa. The ball is loose, and Kansas City has it.
Davis, the linebacker, recovered it.
Anthony Davis, number 50, comes up with it for the Chiefs. And they do have a breath of life with a minute 13 left, although they are out of timeouts.
Well, that's all right, but you've painted the two of the three parts here. They got the touchdown. They do get the onside kick. This bounces off two players. I mean, one there, and then off Belcher, 29, who
Belcher
just made the tackle.
Great shot at it.
Yep, Anthony Davis on the recovery.
So Infante sweats this one out. Ball squarely at midfield.
And you want to be a football coach, huh? Just another day at the office for these two gentlemen.
Plenty of time left, even without the timeouts. Minute 13 for Bono. Trying to pull it out of the fire for Kansas City. Four wideouts. Bono steps up, delivers, and the pass is complete to Tamarik Vanover.
I think that's his first catch of the day.
Second catch for Vanover.
He runs a great pattern. They're going to give him soft coverage here. Runs the out. Dedrick Mathis again in coverage. Comes back for the football. Why can't you throw it to him more often?
Clock running under 50 seconds left. Run to 37. Photo pass complete. Tight roping is LaChapelle. And he's down to the 11-yard line. Clock continues to roll. We'll see the spike. You can see the Chiefs.
Wait a minute, we got an injured player. We got an injured player here.
It is Eugene Daniel down. Or is he faking it? Now he pops right back up. And Bono spikes it.
Who missed the tackle? LaChapelle makes the catch. The defender for the Colts is expecting him to go out of bounds. And he continues to run down the sideline. Somebody from the Colts gave up on the play. I could not pick out who it was. We're going to see here. Out to the right, it's 40 McElroy. He thinks he's going out of bounds.
Look at LaChapelle, tightrope down. And that is Eugene Daniel.
Oh, McElroy.
24 to 19, 23 seconds left. Kansas City took over after recovering the onside kick and now has it at the Colt 11-yard line.
There's McElroy. He gave up on the play. Watch again. Now watch LaChapelle's feet. But you can see McElroy just give up. And LaChapelle does a great job of staying in bounds. I mean, that's as close as you can get. He looked like a tightrope walker there. I think they were called the Walenzas. The
Walendas.
Walendas, close enough.
That was the that was LaChapelle doing the tightrope act down the sidelines. He has been impressive today. Six catches, 70 yards for LaChapelle.
And I had Kansas City buried out of here. What are they going to do a minute and a half ago?
From the 11, second down and 10. Bono lofting it up, incomplete. That was Chris Penn in the end zone. Clock stops, 18 seconds. Field goal will not get it done. Kansas City needs the touchdown.
This is when you're glad to have a coach on the sideline calling the plays. Paul Hackett upstairs is trying to make stuff up here to get the ball in the end zone. A win by Kansas City, and they're in the playoffs.
Third down. Again, 10 from the 11. Bono finds some time, throwing it out of bounds. And again, that was LaChapelle. 13 seconds to go. Fourth down. This is the play.
What are they, 3 of 4 on fourth downs? Or 3 of 3 on fourth downs? Kansas City is today. Now the number we get is 2 of 4, but no, they've had 3 fourth downs converted.
So with 13 seconds left, this is the play for Kansas City. Bono to the end zone, incomplete. Danan Hughes, the intended receiver.
Pass is incomplete, intended for Danan Hughes.
And the Colts take over on downs, and that should do it with 9 seconds to go.
Well, they made it exciting.
What a disappointing loss for the Chiefs, who again have to head to Buffalo. With their playoff hopes still on the line, this was the last gasp effort to Hughes.
Now, this is just a simple square out. And there's good coverage.
He had Dedrick a chance
Mathis,
at that.
Yeah, Dedrick Mathis is there again. We've called Dedrick Mathis' name a lot. They're looking for a flag, any kind of intercept or interference of any sort, but Colts win.
The Indianapolis Colts will move to 9-6. Kansas City will fall to 9-6. Harbaugh will take the knee. Kansas City defenseless to stop the clock, out of timeouts. And what an impressive victory for Lindy Infante and Indianapolis. They win it by a final score of 24-19. They win their third game in a row. The first one coming against Buffalo. Then they beat the Eagles, knowing that their playoff hopes were on the line, that they needed to squeeze out victories. And then they come into Arrowhead Stadium, one of the most difficult venues in the NFL, and they knock off the Chiefs 24-19. How do you explain it?
I don't know. As they've continued to do it, this is a team that just does not give up on itself. You have to beat the Indianapolis Colts. They seldom beat themselves. And again, huge plays by the Indianapolis Colts is the plus side. The downside for Kansas City is they continue to give up big plays.
Well, this is what we know right now. This is the wild card race up to the minute. Kansas City at 9-6. Indianapolis also at 9-6. Buffalo has the Monday night game in Miami. And again, the Chiefs will head to Buffalo for their final regular season game, still not with a playoff spot clinched.
It might still come down to a coin flip somewhere.
So the final 24-19. So for Bob Trumpy, I'm Dan Hicks, saying so long from Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. We're going to send you to Mile High Stadium to join Dick Enberg, Phil Simms, and Paul McGuire for the conclusion of the Raiders versus the Broncos. The Colts win it here in Kansas City. Let's send you to Denver.